If you think getting a lot of kills is the way to win the battle,
you're wrong.
Your number one priority should be to follow orders. When the commander says to do something, you will need to do it without any question. Because without you, we will lose. You see, more often than not, a lot of people think that they're not important as individual rankers. But you are wrong again. You all, as individual rankers, big or small, amazing or trash at the game. Your contributions to the battle is so vital in securing your team the victory. If you really want to give your team the win, you have to realize that your life in the game is worthless. You will die again and again and again. But when you were alive, was your life useful to your team? Did you sacrifice yourself in a charging block, or did you go by yourself to die and lose 4 tickets? Which brings me to the next point. When charging, what you want to do is go inside of each other. And no, I mean literally, you want to go inside each other. Going in a blob or a clump will make your charge so much more effective. This will kill the enemy instantly once stabbed simultaneously by your giant blob. What you don't want to do is go by yourself, because that's how you get yourself killed. And that's how you lose 4 tickets. And that's a lot. That's a lot. For one person, that is a lot. Compare this to dying in a line formation, which only loses 1 ticket, while group formation loses 2. Imagine if everyone goes by themselves and loses 4 tickets. We don't want that, do we? So the next time you're charging, look for a friendly that's closest to the enemy line and clump up on him or her. Your objective when charging should be the enemy's flag, and you should ignore any enemy stragglers who are low on morale. These stragglers are pretty much ineffective, and your team's flag defense, the people who protect your flag, will be the ones who deal with them. The flag defense will wear a different uniform or change their looks to distinguish themselves from rankers. These guys always stick with the flag, especially when charging. If your commander orders a charge, you will charge. Even if you have no morale or you need to reload, you must put yourself in the thick of danger to sacrifice your life for the team. Spacing out the line is super important. It decreases the chance of you dying from a bullet. And as I stated in my other video, when you shoot, your shots will be within a cone. The more people inside the cone, the more likely it is to hit. So to counter this, why not try to space out? Each regiment have their own standards of spacing distance, but what you want to do is try to space out as much as possible, as long as you have the line formation buff. You should try to space out as soon as the commander tells you to quick form. Each regiment, however, have their own ways of saying it. It could be form up to my left and right, or form and present, and or there's just many other ways to say it. Whatever the case may be, if the commander says to prepare to quick form, you will spread yourselves out to form a line as soon as the commander stops walking. Everyone should have their own spot when the line is formed. But if someone takes your spot, don't be angry. Just move to the end of the line. It's as simple as that. This is so that we form the line with speed and efficiency. Adding on to that, there's a little trick you can do to reduce your hitbox. However, this is somewhat controversial, as some people says it works, some people says it doesn't work. Whichever the case may be, turning left or right while standing is said to reduce your hitbox, as it is turned sideways. In addition to this, crouching will reduce your hitbox, making it harder for the enemies to hit you, but also comes at the price of a slow reloading speed. As I stated in my other videos, morale is important. It determines how effective and how accurate your performance can be in the game. So of course, you want to keep it as high as possible. This can be achieved by staying near the flag or chanting at the same time. If everyone chants together simultaneously, you'll be given a morale boost. And during a battle, a chanter will say something like, chant in 3, 2, 1, chant, or 3, 2, 1, chant. Either way, you have to press Q and chant when the officer says so.
Chant in 3, 2, 1, chant.
For example, I like to say chant in 3, 2, 1, chant, and then chant when I say the word chant. It's getting kind of confusing, but yeah. Some people, however, like to say chant in 3, 2, 1, and chant when they say the word 1. You'll just have to adapt to your chanter's style of doing it. The concept's pretty much the same. Usually, if you're in a normal French-speaking regiment, your default chant should be Long Live France. This is what we call selective chanting, where we specifically use one chant. However, this is not extremely strict, especially when charging, different regiments have different default chants. The officer in your regiment will tell you what their default chant is, so don't worry about it. Lastly, just remember that to truly achieve victory, you will need to put the team over yourself. Doesn't matter how many times you've died, as long as those deaths were in the best interests of your team. Maybe you can try body blocking the flag so it doesn't get sniped in the retreat. Maybe when you're charging with zero morale, you can sacrifice yourself as a meat shield to protect those who have morale. You just need to know how to play not for yourself, but for the team. If you want to learn more about the basics of campaigns, like how to shoot, how to join a regiment, etc., please check out my other videos. And if you have any questions, you can ask me in my Discord, or you can just comment below.
I present fire.
Holy
shit. Oh my god.
Alright.
What do you mean, Italy? That's Spain.
Oh, main. Good job.
Oh my god.
Good job.
The fudge.
What the hell? Alright. Please.
Pivot. Quickly. Piss off, Michael. You're no good. Stay calm.